So today, Assalamu alaikum students, today I'll be teaching you all English. So today we will be completing our unit 7A, that is the wonderful world of chess. So there are many games that require physical as well as mental activity. Games like cricket, tennis, badminton, long jump, these are few games that require physical activity, whereas games like your carrom, chess, these requires your mental activity and your attention towards the game. So this is, today we will be learning about chess. Now chess is a world renowned game. It is played by many people and the winners are considered to be grandmasters because it requires a lot of intelligence. Now today we will be learning how this is played. First let us start with the coins. Now this is your chess board. Now this one, that is your elephant. Elephant is called as rook. R-O-O-K, rook. And the very next to rook you have horse and it is called as knight. K-N-I-G-H-T, knight. Now after knight, beside knight we have bishop. Bishop, that is none other than camel. That is B-I-S-H-O-P, bishop. That is none other than camel. Now we have, very next to bishop we have queen. We have queen. Queen is nothing but the minister or mantri of the board game. Now very next to her we have king. Very next to her we have king. King is nothing but king of the board. Now these are the pawns. These are the pawns that are soldiers of our chess board. Now let us do the introduction. I am reading the introduction of this first lesson, the wonderful world of chess. Kingdoms have vanished, kings have gone, but one game they have played remained with us and probably remains with us forever is chess. It has won the hearts of Indians, Egyptians, Persians, Chinese, Japanese and every thinking animal on the earth. What is it that made it so clear, dear to our hearts? Different people give different reasons. Now, as I said you, kingdoms have vanished, kings have gone, but one game that have remained with us is probably the chess. So this chess is played from Mahabharata times to till today. And this is one in its hearts. This is having its own place in everyone's hearts, be it irrespective of cities or countries or religions or caste or colors. Maybe Chinese, it may be a Chinese, Japanese, Indians, Egyptians or Persians. Everyone has their own different place when it comes to chess. Now, we don't know what it made it so dear to us. Okay, now we will be reading history of this game. This wonderful game of chess is a gift of India to the world. The Hindus believe that it was invented by Queen Mandodari, the king of the wife of King Ravana. However, historians H.J.R. Murray holds that it was invented by a scholar from northwest India around 5th century. In those days, it called Chaturanga, the four divisions of the military. Now, it is saying, the history of chess is saying that chess is a gift to the world from India, from mythological India. It is said that this chess game was invented by Queen Mandodari, who was wife of King Ravana. The Queen Mandodari has invented this game and she was none other than wife of King Ravana. However, history H.J.R. Murray say that no, it was not invented by Queen Mandodari, but it was invented by a great scholar somewhere from northwest India. So in those days it was called as not chess, but it was called as Chaturanga. It was called as Chaturanga, the four divisions of military.